So in this session, we will be seeing about the mushrooms that are a powerhouse of nutrition. So mushrooms are considered as a powerhouse of nutrition. Why? Because it is rich in many minerals and many nutrients. So mushrooms will be an alternative source for the vegetarians. It will give the nutrients which is present in the non-veg foods. And if the non-vegetarians are in diet or in some kind of restriction with the non-veg foods like meat, that is goat meat or sheep meat or chickens, they can replace the that food with the mushrooms. So mushrooms are low in calories because it doesn't have any rich source of carbohydrate. So carbohydrates are giving high calorie as well as protein. So if it is rich in protein also, it will gives you high calorie. So it has that not that much complex protein and the carbohydrate. So it is very it has very less calories and the fat when compared to protein, the fat is also very less in mushrooms. So it is cholesterol free. Okay, so there will be age restriction after 35. Nobody should should have uncontrolled diet. Okay, so everybody should have a controlled diet of diet to be followed in the food, but with some restrictions like fried foods and other things. So at that time, this mushroom will be an alternative for them to compensate with their to replace with their non-veg food items. Okay, mushrooms contain a modest amount of fiber and over a dozen of minerals and vitamins. So minerals rich in minerals that includes copper, potassium, magnesium, zinc, a number of B vitamins such as folate. Folate is very, very essential for the proper functioning of the reproductive system of women. So folate helps us in developing the ovaries and it will help you to be active, okay? Active in your health. So the uterine health is more essential for the women to be healthy. Okay, and mushrooms are also high in antioxidants. So antioxidants are the compound which protect the cells from cell damage. If the continuous cell damage happens in the cell, it will lead to tumor or cancer. Okay, so these antioxidants which is present in the mushrooms, they'll help us to overcome or get escaped from the cancer like deadly diseases and also from importantly from aging. Okay, so you should consume mushroom in a proper way, and the mushroom should not be over fried or eating with over masalas. Okay, so you should cook properly and eat, prepare soups, prepare some salads, that sabzis like vegetable stocks and vegetable stews. Okay, so along with that you can eat these mushrooms boiled, not deeply fried like things. Okay, so mushrooms are rich in high rich in antioxidant. And it has selenium and glutathione. These are the very popular antioxidant and substance believed to protect cells from damage and reduce the chronic disease and inflammations. So mushrooms are the richest dietary source of another antioxidant called ergothioneine. So why I have separately put these antioxidants are, so all mushrooms don't have the same antioxidants. So each food item, each mushrooms have different antioxidant composition. Okay, so these mushrooms are the richest dietary source, another different types like butter mushrooms are there, oyster mushrooms are there. So all these mushrooms are different dietary sources. Okay, so ergothionine is present in the another type of mushrooms. So mushrooms are, there are two types of mushrooms. One is edible mushrooms and one another one is the medicinal mushrooms. So all medicinal mushrooms are not eatable. All medicinal mushrooms are not eatable one or not edible one. Okay, you can use edible mushroom alone for your cooking, not the medicinal mushrooms. Medicinal mushrooms are used for curing some diseases. Only the extraction will be taken and that extract will be used for treating some diseases, and it is also used as an antioxidants. Okay, and some mushrooms also contain vitamin D. So vitamin D are the richest source which is present in the mushrooms. So when we expose to sunlight only, we can able to synthesize, our cell able to synthesize vitamin D. But in case of mushrooms, it is readily available in the mushroom. So if we consume mushroom, the vitamin D will be, we are gaining from it, okay? So and another one is a low risk of developing breast cancer. So another important thing is breast cancer. Already told you, antioxidant will fight against oxidation of the cell. So it will prevent from cellular damage. And also it prevent the cells from cancers. Okay, the breast cells, breast cancer cells will be prevented. And if we consume more mushrooms, it will lower the risk of developing breast cancer. And dementia. So dementia is another kind of disease that is associating with the brain. So this is a neurodegenerative disease. So it will, once the disease is there with the patient, they will have a poor memory. So it will hit only after the age of 45. Okay, 45 is the minimum age now. Okay. Maximum it will be after 65. Okay. So dementia will be the another neurodegenerative disease if we consume mushrooms regularly, at least in a week or thrice in a month. It will protect all our cells from damage and it prevent us from aging. Okay, we can delay our aging of our cells to look young, and stay healthy. Okay, so these are the nutritional aspects of mushrooms. This is because of these nutritional aspects and important phytocompounds like glutathione, selenium and ergothionine. This will make the important the economical value of these mushroom will get increased and this will rise to the economical importance. Okay, so all these things make this mushroom more economically important and it will be in the higher range as the status of the mushroom is highest in the global market. And in a few 10 decades, that is before 10 years, okay, there is no that much aware about the mushroom. Now everybody is very familiar with mushroom and everybody is eating nowadays. But before that, there is no proper awareness. So now the awareness were created by many social medias and research, and medical practitioners are giving awareness to consume a healthy food and healthy diet for proper functioning of the organs in the body. So this makes to rise the market level of the mushroom globally. Okay, so this is all about the nutritional values of the mushroom, nutritional aspect of the mushroom and the economical value why it has. Okay, thank you.